Setting this to repeat. This is Ellie Perkins from Valentine's Detective Agency with a message for Nick's partner. We've got a new case and it sounds urgent. Stop by the office. I'll be waiting. Setting this to repeat. This is Ellie Perkins from Valentine's Detective Agency with a message for Nick's partner.
Shoot people, sir?
My dad says outside to shoot people.
24 hours, sir!
I'm glad you're here. We got a new case while you and Nick were out. Ready to put on the detective hat?
Who's our client?
A fisherman whose family lives on the edge of the Commonwealth. Kenji Nakano.
Nakano? Huh. That name takes me back. My memory's a little fuzzy on the details, though.
Maybe if you bothered writing things down, Nick.
Can't do that. Wouldn't want to put you out of a job.
Huh. I'll remember that the next time you need me to console a hysterical client. Mr. Nakano didn't leave many details. Said he'd go over everything when you meet him. But if you want my guess, missing person case. Guy had a worried look a mile long.
Anything you can tell me about Kenji Nakano?
Just some impressions. He was obviously upset, but he was also in a hurry. Like, he couldn't stand just waiting around. I'm a friend of Nick's. He'll remember me. I need his help right away. And then he was gone. He was muttering something on the way out, but... no. I'm not sure it was important.
Come on, Ellie. Don't hold out on me. What did he say?
Well, I thought I heard him say something about a daughter and also a radio, but... I might have misheard him. Not sure how the two would be connected.
I'll go check it out. Thanks, Ellie.
The Nakano residence is up in the northeast.
It's a long walk. That's how the hard cases always start.
Hey, Valentine.
Time to hit the road?
Let's head out.
Well, all right.
Of the Commonwealth slept soundly, for the greatest monster was gone. It took a lot of guts to do what you did. I know it couldn't have been easy. Then.
Right away. She could be hurt. She could be...
Whoa, slow down. Kenji, was it? Why did you go over the details with me and my partner here?
You brought a partner? Good. The more eyes, the better.
So, what's the story with you and Nick?
That is not important right now. You have to help me find my daughter.
Yeah, that's me. Lowly partner. I don't even get real business cards.
Right. Getting back to my daughter. It all started with this damn radio.
Our daughter Kasumi likes to fix things. The radio was her latest project.
Until she made contact with some kidnapper who lured her away from us.
Or maybe she left on her own. She's not a child anymore. Our daughter is 19. She knows how to survive and she's capable. I think maybe she left because she wanted her own life.
No. She would have told us where she was going. She would have said something. I know my daughter is in danger. I can feel it. Find her, please.
Do you have any idea where she could have gone?
We know she took one of the boats, but that's all. She could be anywhere.
We'll find her. Don't you worry.
Thank you. Her room is upstairs, if that helps. And if you had any more questions about her, just ask.
Don't worry, Kenji. We'll get to the bottom of this. Just sit tight.
Mr. Nakano.
Did you have questions? About my daughter?
Anything more you can tell me about Kasumi? The smallest detail could be important.
I don't know what more to say. She's my little girl, and she doesn't know how dangerous this world is. I never should have let her grandfather teach her how to fix these machines.
Her grandfather? He taught her how to fix the radio?
Ever since she was old enough to walk, yes. Her grandfather had an ear for machines. Kasumi picked up the knack. He passed away recently. He used to scavenge the ruins in the south for parts. I kept telling him he was getting too old.
Tell me more about this radio she was fixing.
I've tried to get that damn thing to work over and over again, but there's nothing. I thought she just wanted to strip it for parts or build a toaster out of it or something, like she usually does. Someone made contact with her, and then they took her. God, what kind of twisted psychopath has my daughter?
Why did your daughter really leave? Your wife says she left on her own, but you said it was kidnappers.
I know it was kidnappers. Kasumi is a smart girl, but she doesn't know how horrible people can be. Not like me and Rei. Why would she just leave her family with no explanation? Someone tricked her. Got her to leave the safety of home. Every minute we aren't looking for my daughter, her life is in jeopardy.
No more questions right now.
Work quickly, Detective.
Mrs. Nakano.
I suppose you have questions about my daughter.
You and your husband don't seem to agree about why your daughter left.
We both want to find her. The world out there isn't a place where you want to be alone. But Kenji still sees her swaddled in diapers. He doesn't see a young woman with her own decisions to make. Maybe because it's more frightening. She wasn't tricked into leaving without telling us. That was her choice. She didn't want us to follow. Why?
I'd like to know more about Kasumi. Might shine a light on where she's gone.
My daughter is strong, focused, careful. That's how I know she's still alive. But why would she leave without telling us? Maybe we... No, never mind. I don't want to waste your time.
Every detail is important, Mrs. Nakano. Don't hold back.
No, it's nothing. I don't want to distract you, Detective.
Tell me more about this radio your daughter was working on.
I remember Kasumi was very excited about it. I figured she was secretly trying to make contact with Diamond City or another settlement. We're pretty isolated out here. She only has us for company, and Kenji can be overprotective.
Every detail?
No, it's nothing.
Nothing else right now. Your thoughts?
See if you can find any of Kasumi's personal effects. Anything to give us a clue to where she went.
Nothing else for now.
Got it.
This is Kasumi's room. Let's see if she left any clues about where she went.
Project log? Radio. Correction. Working radio. I'll finally get some news outside this house. My handle is going to be... Let's go with... Ohm's Law. That should confuse the creeps. And if someone actually gets the reference, then... We'll at least have circuitry in common.
Let's keep looking. Need to figure out what Kasumi's story was. Why she left.
log? Kitchen mixer. The circuits are still good, but all the mechanical parts are rusted through. Maybe I can...
All right, everyone. I'll be back in a few days. Was there anything else we needed from the city?
Wait, you're going now?
No!
Wait, Dad, I could come with you.
It is better if I go alone, Kasumi. Do not worry. I have your list.
You don't know what half that list is, Dad. I can help you. Really, I'll be...
I said no. I'm sorry. You're safe here, okay? Just stay put for me.
Okay.
I know you're disappointed, but I won't be long. I love you.
I love you too, Dad. Project Log, Radiation King Television. Mom says these things actually used to broadcast pictures and sounds back before the war. She also mentioned that some of the ruins of the television studios are still around if you head to the city. Of course, she wasn't too happy when I asked if we could make a trip out there. I'm getting off track. I managed to repair the vacuum tubes and got the power working again, but, well, it's not like there's any working signal for this thing to receive. I'm just going to start stripping this thing for parts moving forward.
Hey.
There's something bothering you?
Your thoughts?
Let's take a look around.
That's all for now.
Well, all right.
Hidden key, huh? Good work. Just gotta find whatever it unlocks.
What I am, but... God. Where do I start? The radio. I was right about the range. I managed to get a signal, a strong signal, from up north.
Otter takes off by boat. But more importantly, there's a colony of synths up near this far harbor. We need a way to get there. Let's go talk to Kenji. He knows the waters better than anyone.
Finished your investigation? Did you find anything?
I need to ask you an important question. Are you sure your daughter is human?
What kind of question is that? Why are you asking?
Your daughter made contact with a group of synths. She thinks she's one of them.
What? That's crazy.
She's not a synth. She's our daughter. We raised her. I gave birth to her. She's flesh and blood, not a synthetic.
Are you sure she's human, Mrs. Nakano?
Yes, I know my daughter and she hasn't changed. She's not some replacement.
This is what I was afraid of. Someone twisting my daughter's mind. Did you find where Kasumi went, Detective?
I think Kasumi took off somewhere up north. Do you know what's up there?
Where specifically? I've been up the coast, almost to where the waters start to freeze, but that's a lot of miles.
I think I know where Kasumi went. A place called Far Harbor.
She went that far up north? God, that explains why she took the boat. You have to go after her. Please, take my other ship on the dock outside. My father's design. It has a guidance system, and it is built for distance.
What can I expect out there, Kenji?
I only made the trip to Far Harbor once, when I was a boy. All I remember is that my father did not want to stay long. Something about the air being bad.
I'll get to the bottom of this, Kenji.
Thank you. I know you haven't asked for a payment, and we can't offer much. But here, please take it. I insist. For expenses, if nothing else.
I know it'll be hard waiting for word, but try to carry on like normal. We'll be back as soon as we can.
Fine, Kasumi. Please.
Farming's as honest work gets.
Thank you.
one synth safely out of harm's way.
And here is your amply deserved reward.
More news on the LNL gang. Stevie Buchanan is negotiating with another gang, trying to drum up allies. If we take him out before those negotiations are complete, it'll make our job easier down the line. You know what to do.
It'll be my pleasure.
Just stay careful.
Desdemona.
The end is in sight. All the sacrifices, the fallen, it paid off in the end. Whisper, aren't you? I've been looking for you. Name's Boxer. Boss called me in on account of some rumors making their way through the Commonwealth. There's word that there's some kind of colony of synths way up the coast, all on their own. You heard anything like that?
Following a lead on a place called Far Harbor.
Never heard of it. Doesn't mean it's not connected, though. If you're already looking into it, don't let me stop you. Just let me know if you find anything, okay?
Visitors around here.
We don't need no freeloaders or more help, Mainlander. So you can get back in your boat and leave.
Alan, this isn't your dock. It belongs to the whole town. And that means strangers are welcome. Sorry, you've caught us during a difficult time. But Alan's got a point. Not all visitors have good intentions. So, what's your business here?
A young woman from the Commonwealth named Kasumi may have passed through here. Her family hired me to find her.
Some sort of detective, huh? Well, she came through here all right.
At least we know she made it this far.
Damn it. Mariners ain't coming.
Something's coming through the fog!
You, help us defend the town and I'll answer any questions you have. Take a post at the top of the wall near the main gate. The hall never lets us down. Now follow me!
Careful!
to the fog. They're coming.
Defend yourself!
Radio!
Visitors around here.
We don't need no freeloaders or more help, Mainlander. So you can get back in your boat and leave.
Alan, this isn't your... Sorry. You've... But Alan's got a point. Not...
A young woman from the Commonwealth named Kasumi.
Some sort of detective, huh? Well...
At least we know she...
Damn it. Mariners ain't coming.
Something's coming through the fog!
You... Help us defend the town, and I'll answer any questions you have. Take a post at the top of the wall near the main gate. The hall never lets us down. Now follow me!
No time. Look to the fog. They're coming.
Oh, God! Defend yourselves!
Radio! Fire at will!
Still in one piece. Can't hardly believe it.
Avery.
And now you see what we're up against. The fog and creatures it spits out have taken the whole island from my people. For your help when we needed it, you deserve this.
What's the fog?
Where to begin? The fog's radioactive, right? But there are pockets of it. The deep fog. That are hard fallout. And as deadly as that is, that's only part of the problem. Things live in the fog, thrive. You think what attacked the harbor's bad? Oh, there's far worse further inland.
You've lost the whole island?
Oh, the fog's been here forever. There are good years when it recedes and the island's almost normal. Then there are times when it spreads all over. And people have to cling to any patch of land free of the fog. For the past, 8 years or so, it's been getting as bad as it's ever been. Now, Far Harbor's one of the only places left that's safe.
If you manage to survive despite all that, you must be tough.
Ornery, more like.
I'm done cowering behind your damn hull, Avery. Time you let me deal with the real problem. With the right people and my guns, I can end those Children of Adam cultists for good.
The fog's been here forever. The children didn't make it.
Before the Rat Eaters came, the fog was under control. They come, and it all goes wrong. It's time we do something.
No need to burden the stranger with all this nonsense.
Have the children made the fog worse?
Absolutely not. There's not one bit of evidence.
Geiger counters don't lie, Avery. Fog's gotten more lethal year over year. And now the fog's covering the whole island. But only after the children came.
You know as well as I do, that's happened before. Sure, people have theories the children are involved, but no one, and I mean no one, has proof.
Sounds like you should deal with the Children of Adam. Permanently.
I'm not sure that's going to make our job here easier.
The mainlander sees the sense in all this.
I will do everything in my power to keep the peace here. So go, Alan. Sorry for all that. You're here for Kasumi, right? She headed inland to the Synth Refuge, Acadia. Getting there will be dangerous. You'll need a guide. Old Longfellow. No one knows the fog like him. But word of warning, he's a bit of an acquired taste.
What's old Longfellow's story?
He's the best hunter on the island. Fearless. Some say crazy. If someone needs to get to Acadia, he's the only one that'll do it. But people around here are known for being stubborn, willful, and other less flattering things. But Longfellow's got a reputation even among us.
What can you tell me about Acadia?
Ask Longfellow. He's the only one that's been there.
Thanks for the info.
Best place to look for Longfellow's at the bar. The last plank. And, please, lend a hand around town if you're able. Even if it's slapped away, people like the Mariner and Cassie and others need help. And let me say something you might not hear again. Thank you.
Are the source of all our problems. Every single one of them.
Alan.
Huh. The mainlander. Great. You helped us on Mariner's Hull, but we didn't need it. This is our island. Our fight. Not yours.
Don't you want a helping hand?
Hell no. Once you start leaning on people, soon you can't walk no good on your own. What happens next time when you ain't here, huh? Or the next? Either us harbormen survive on our own terms, or we take the long walk together. But there's one exception. That is, if you meant what you said to Avery about the Children of Adam. Anyone willing to put those bastards down? I'll sell my top shelf ordnance too with a smile.
I'm still thinking about it.
Great.
Hey, Alan.
We doing business?
I'll take a look.
Let's deal.
Boot in front.
Talk with Alan. I don't have time for you.
I got the guns if you got the caps.
What's your problem with the Children of Adam?
We should have gunned those bastards down the moment they set foot here. Instead, we let them in. All in secret from wherever they're holed up. They've been feeding the fog. Getting it stronger. Strong enough to push us all out of our homesteads. Further and further until it's a wonder we're not all drowned in the ocean.
Do you have any proof that they've fed the fog?
Proof? We wait for that and we might as well pull the trigger ourselves. Look, my daddy's time, the fog was a nuisance. Something you avoided. Now every day it gets stronger. It's like the fires of hell out there. Because of the children.
I'll pass.
Is anybody gonna buy anything? Don't let the island catch you off guard. Buy my guns.
I could use time.
Bye.
Hello.
You're that mainlander who just got here. Better watch yourself, because this island sees and hears everything you do. I should know. I watched the island tear down the greatest family that ever set foot in Far Harbor. It's a tale of greed, blood, and vengeance.
What family are you talking about?
I was just about to explain. My family, the Daltons, was the pride of Far Harbor for generations, even back before the war. It was lumber and fishing that made the Daltons rich. But they got greedy, took too much from the island. The island's been getting revenge ever since, killing us off one by one. I'm the last Dalton still standing. Ah! But now our story takes an unexpected turn. A mysterious stranger comes to Far Harbor. Someone strong, someone capable. With the stranger's help, the last living Dalton finally has a chance to avenge her bloodline once and for all.
Wait, are you saying that I'm the mysterious stranger who's gonna help you avenge your family?
Ah, you're a quick one. Good. You'll need your wits about you. Because your part in the story is filled with danger. Now, on to the first chapter in our tale of vengeance. That would be the sad story of Freckle-Faced Petey. Petey was my cousin. He was a good lad, never caused trouble. He thought all those freckles brought him luck, but, well, not so much. He was out foraging at the National Park campground when the island sicked some feral ghouls on him. Island's a sneaky bastard when it wants to be. Anyway, he made it back to town, but died from his injuries that night. Of course, those ferals are still out there, waiting to kill the next poor fool who comes along. Damn shame.
Where did you say these ghouls were?
National Park Campground. It's pretty much straight west of here.
Those ghouls are as good as dead.
Good, good. It's long past time those shamblers paid for what they did to Petey.
Supplies at the bait shop.
Bait shop's got everything you need.
Children of Adam.
Mariner.
The hull took a battering. To be sure. But she wouldn't be standing at all if it weren't for you. They call me the Mariner. Shipwright, handyman, the only one keeping the harbor afloat, beside Captain Avery.
A pleasure to meet you.
Likewise. I hope the island doesn't kill you quick. Or slow, for that matter.
I don't suppose you'd be willing to lend a hand. In order to do proper repairs, I need tools. Specialized tools. And they won't be easy to come by. 450 caps if you can, though.
You've kept the walls together this long. Why do you need special tools now?
I want to build the hull up proper. Make it strong. And keep those blasted crabs out. We're good.
So I'd be risking my life for only 450 caps.
The pay is what the pay is. Are you in or out?
Sign me up. I'll help.
Eagle's Cove Tannery. Tools are certain to be there. Now get.
If you ain't armed, you ain't long for this world. Buy my guns now.
Conversation here.
Shut your mouths, open your damned ears. So the fogs are coming for us all, and I can't see any better way of greeting it than to have another round. On the howl!
We're the only bar in town.
Time to party!
Captain Avery said you can get me to Acadia.
Heard there was a scuffle out there. You get your hands dirty? I'm done leading people to their deaths in the fog. Last fella couldn't keep up. Didn't last 5 minutes.
Can you tell me about Acadia?
Strange folk like there. Call themselves Synths. Seems to me they just want to be left alone, to live their life in peace. They've done some good turns for us islanders. The fog condensers, most especially, wouldn't even be a far harbor left without those.
Some parents are worried about their runaway daughter. She went to Acadia, and I need to find her.
If someone's headed for Acadia, there's always a story. Yours worth dying over, huh?
Yeah. I've done a whole lot more for a whole lot less.
If that's the way you choose to live, that's your affair.
Look, if that girl's in some kind of trouble, time could be...
Value.
Captain Avery said you can get me to Acadia.
Heard there was a scuffle out there. You get your hands dirty? I'm done leading people to their deaths in the fog. Last fella couldn't keep up. Didn't last 5 minutes.
Some parents are worried.
Someone's headed for Acadia.
Yeah, I've done...
Clever with words. I can get you to Acadia, but you've got to listen to me. Go where I say, when I say it. Still won't be easy. You stock up on your necessities, Rad X and the like, and then the real work can begin.
Let's go, Longfellow.
Follow me.
Conversation here.
Shut your mouths, open your damned ears. So the fogs are coming for us all. I can't see any better way of greeting it than to have a...
Hey there.
Deep fog has all manner of nasties.
Ow.
Yeah!
Trapper in the eyes. Something else.
Talk to Cassie, Bill. Shame on that.
Old mouth. seen it coming. Start flying, find cover. Keep your head down if you want to live. Still got a ways to go. Best we steer clear. But you never know. Taking things for granted, folk got short memories. All this has happened before. We ain't alone.
One more soul to their damnation.
Well, what have we here? Another rad worshiping lunatic, that's what.
Your barbs do not harm me. I am shielded by my faith.
How about bullets? Faith shield you against those too?
Who's she?
One of them children of Adam preachers. Started off as pests. Now they're more like a menace.
Do not sully this one with your blasphemy, old man. You, I suggest you go no further. Acadia is a nest of snakes, beasts that subvert the will of Adam.
Yeah, whatever you say.
Watch yourself, outsider. You walk through Adam's kingdom now.
If you're done wasting time with a fanatic, let's move on. Acadia's already been watching us for a good spell. If you want to talk with them, just go inside. They'll be waiting for you. You need my help again, you come see me. Got a cabin just outside of Far Harbor. Good place to tool up your gear, get some rest, or get stinking drunk. Just make sure if you bring in a bottle of something strong, there's enough to share.
Leaving already? Don't you want to see what happens next?
You saying you want me to stick around and watch your back?
Maybe later, Mark.
All right. But I'm serious about the offer. You ever want to hunt the forests and waters of the island together? I can think of worse things to do. Just once, let me find a pair of socks that don't have holes.
This mountain above the fog, I thought to myself, now here is a metaphor worth taking in. You've entered a place of clarity, understanding, peace. While you're here in Acadia, Synthkind welcomes you as long as you welcome us.
What are you?
I told you. I'm the old synth on the mountain. I know the plastic skin and tubes out the back can be unsettling, but I want to ask you to look past that. Tell me why you're here, and I'll try to help you.
I came here looking for Kasumi Nakano.
Really? I'm impressed. Few would brave the kind of journey you've had for the sake of someone else. Kasumi is here. She's safe and unharmed, and you're free to see her if you'd like. Before you do, though, tell me, you think Kasumi is a synth?
We're not answering any more questions until you play straight with us. Just who the hell are you, really? There's only one synth with that kind of face and a mind of his own, and I only see him when I look in a mirror.
Nick? It can't be you.
Don't give me that. What are you trying to pull? I've never seen you before in my life.
Please, if you're willing to give me a chance, I can explain.
Is this a joke? Do you really know Nick?
Let me tell you what I know, and you can judge for yourself. We were prototypes, Nick. The first synths capable of independent thinking and judgment.
Keep talking.
One of the Institute's experiments had to do with how our brains could process personality. If we could handle individualized feelings and behaviors, I was allowed to develop mine based on experience. But with you, they wanted to try transferring an entire personality into you. It took several attempts before the personality imprint worked. I saw you wake up not knowing who or what you were so many times. I couldn't let them do it to you anymore. We were the only two prototypes they made. I literally saw myself in you. You were my brother, Nick. I helped you escape the Institute. We left together.
If I were your brother, I'd remember.
That's where you'd be wrong. This happened over a century ago. There's only so much memory that can fit into the prototype brains we have.
I've heard enough.
I think you and I need to talk about this. Maybe not now, though.
We need to get back to why we're here. Kasumi Nakano.
Nick, I don't need you to believe me. I'm just glad to see you again. Whenever you're ready, I'll be here. Now, about young Kasumi. It's important that you understand exactly why she's here. I asked you before if you think she's really a sin. If you could indulge me with an answer.
what she is important.
But it is. It's everything. Imagine just looking at your own hands and having to wonder, was I born with these, or were they manufactured? None of us take this transition lightly. She's facing the possibility of her entire life being a lie, that someone stripped her very identity from her and made her into something she isn't. I want you to understand that before you see her. She has a chance here to live as a synth, not hiding, not pretending to be something else. One more question, if you'll indulge me. You're here for Kasumi, but I suspect there could be another reason you came to us. Tell me, are you a synth?
I am a human being, not a synth.
Are you sure? I don't mean to question you, but what's the first memory you have?
I remember being in my house the day the bombs fell. We ran to the vault. We were frozen. I was the only survivor.
No memories before then? Just a single day? And then waking up alone. We so easily accept what's presented to us as the truth, don't we? Isn't it funny how a memory can feel like a whole different reality? People, places, even sounds and colors can change, or someone else has changed them. I won't lie to you. There will always be other explanations. Trauma, disease, the background radiation. They all take their toll on the mind. But I can promise you that we will accept you, no matter what you decide you are.
I've heard enough. Where's Kasumi Nakano?
Of course. Kasumi is usually working down below. You can see her whenever you like. Acadia is open to you. Feel free to walk the grounds. Introduce yourself to my co-founders, Faraday and Chase. Did you need anything else before you go?
Who are you? What's your story?
I came to this island over a century ago, hiding from my creators, the Institute. But after my escape felt secured, I was left with nothing. No programmed task. No false memories. I spent a year just sitting in a cave. Just sitting. One day, it finally occurred that maybe I could decide for myself what to do, who I was. I've been doing that ever since. Was there anything else?
You should know, the Institute has been destroyed.
What? It's over? No more courser hunts? No more slavery? But that also means the technology to make the synths is lost. Our origins have been buried. Not to mention the loss of human life. Sorry. I'm not going to judge the actions of someone who's wiped out great evil. You have our gratitude. Is there anything else you need?
Tell me more about this place, Acadia.
All I want is to bring as many synths here as I can and give them a chance to know what they really are, to embrace it. Beyond that, we just want to live in peace. I don't have any grand plans for expansion. Just existing as we are now is enough. Was there anything else?
I'm part of a group that helps synths. The railroad.
Really? I don't understand why a group dedicated to helping synths would convince them through fear that their only option is to hide. Yes, they volunteer for the memory wipe. Yes, not knowing you're a synth makes it harder for the Institute to find you. But the cost, I know how frightening it is, the risk of capture. But sacrificing what you are, avoiding the true struggle to be accepted as our own form of life?
Ideals aren't going to protect escaped synths. We do what we have to.
I know that's what you think. I just... No. No, I shouldn't judge. I'm over here, far from the Commonwealth, in relative safety. Is there anything else you'd like to discuss?
So, everyone here in Acadia is a synth?
Yes. Either they were escapees we managed to find before the Institute could, or they were victims of a mind wipe, and we revealed the truth to them.
I should get going.
Of course.
Perhaps we're in there a long time. Are you feeling all right?
I'm fine.
Hey.
What? I feel like you know
oh,
enough.
Sorry.
You know we both
got my head full of what Dima was talking
I
about.
You
it's a
right there.
Bit of a shock. Who do you think he is, really? Family?
Before I answer, are you okay?
I'll keep. Don't worry. Just need to figure this all out.
It's hard to deny it, Nick. The similarities are pretty obvious.
I spent a long time wondering if the Institute had made any other prototypes. If I was just a failure, or they gave up, just plain got bored. I always thought I was just more of their discarded trash. I never thought of the possibility that someone wanted me out. Helped me escape. There's got to be some kind of proof out there. What really happened between me and Dima? I'd appreciate it if we could keep an eye out.
What kind of proof would we be looking for?
I don't know. But our best bet is to keep looking into Dima and Acadia.
Of course, Nick. We'll find something.
Thanks. I know we don't have much to go on. Just keep me in mind if you find something that might give us some answers.
Consider helping us. Dima's vision is worth fighting for.
You're right. It is a good cause. Synths definitely deserve to be safe, just like everyone else.
It's so good to hear that. Very encouraging. Please, make sure Dima knows that as well. He's put so much of himself into this. All his time and energy devoted to helping others. He never stops to think of himself. Sometimes I worry about... Well, if I wasn't here to make sure his equipment is all functional. And that's not even mentioning maintaining the fog condensers. So many things to keep track of.
Seems like he's lucky to have you helping.
Thank you. That's very kind.
Dima looks like he's had a lot of work done.
Well, that's certainly an understatement. Between the two of us, we've made so many modifications. He was just a prototype. Never built for all this. It took a lot to overcome the limitations of the original design and expand his memory. It really is remarkable, isn't it? He's overcome so much. He's become so much more than he once was. And all he thinks of is others.
Can you tell me about the fog condensers?
Oh, those? Dima and I designed them when it became clear the fog was only getting worse. They're effective, but have such a limited range. Dima insisted we provide them to the people of Far Harbor, and I'm so glad we did. Without the condensers, I...
If there's anything I can do to help out, just let me know.
Well, if you're determined to help, there is something you could do. It's likely somewhat dangerous, though, so I understand if you'd rather not. There's a boat along the coast of the island. It was transporting some hardware we needed. Storage drives. The boat never finished the trip, you see. So the drives are still out there. I could really use them here for extra parts, if nothing else. My understanding is that the boat wrecked southwest of here. So, does this sound like something you could handle?
What happened to the boat? Why didn't it make it?
I'm not entirely sure, to be honest. Trappers, fog crawlers, there's no end to what's out there. And what might still be out there. The point is that we already lost someone once. And I don't want to see that happen again. So, are you up for it?
Sure thing, Faraday. I'll get the drives for you.
Thank you. I really do appreciate it.
Risks, we get careless, and things can go bad. Fast. If there's a synth who needs a safe place, then we take them in. Let them live as a synth, without fear. You don't fit that description. That makes you an unnecessary risk. It's nothing personal. Minimizing our contact with outsiders is just practical.
Is there anything I can say or do to change your mind?
Just don't cause any problems.
Too, huh? I mean, I haven't been here that long myself. Honestly, I'd be dead right now if it weren't for Chase. Turns out it's pretty hard to live as a synth in the Commonwealth.
It's a tough world. For everyone, not just synths.
I'm not saying it isn't. Just, I'll see you around, okay? If it weren't for Dima, most of us would probably be dead. It might not look like much, but this is the only place I know of where I don't need to hide who I am.
So you're that new fellow from the Commonwealth. It's so wonderful to meet someone from back home. I'm afraid Kasumi doesn't seem to want to discuss it, but how are things there?
Getting better every day, I think.
Oh, that's so good to hear. I would like to see it again someday, once things settle down here. Acadia is all well and good, I suppose, but honestly, it does get a bit boring.
You're safe here. That's what really matters.
I suppose. One could do with a little excitement now and then, though, don't you think? I'm sure I'll see you around. Do take care.
As long as we work together, we can sleep safe knowing we're free.
You want to buy something or what?
Excuse me.
So, I understand you've seen a good bit of our island. What do you think?
No
accounting for taste.
It's kind of beautiful in its own way.
That's refreshing. Most don't view it the same. I'm glad someone else can see it.
This island, with all of its danger and beauty, predates you and I. The ecosystem isn't what it once was, but it has adapted, and it will continue to adapt, long after we're gone. What's important, really important in the long run, is understanding it, and then passing that knowledge along to those who will follow us.
So, what exactly are you doing?
As much as I can, given limited resources. Cataloging specimens, observing evolutionary trends, compiling data for future generations. I should note that I'm not fully versed in human anatomy, but I'm your best chance of medical assistance should you require it. Since Dima has approved of you, I'm more than willing to offer help.
What can you tell me about Acadia?
It was originally a place of science. I like that about it. Feels like home in a way. I don't mean the Institute when I say home. More that, I don't know, that abstract feeling of belonging someplace. We all belong here, in our own way. Dima's to be thanked for that.
Sounds like you got the all clear. So what's your story?
I'm just taking a look around.
Sure you are. Just of your own accord. No particular reason. Nothing to do with that Kasumi girl, right? That Kasumi's a good enough kid, I suppose. A little confused, maybe. But then, aren't we all? Not that anyone's asking, but I'll tell you. It all gets easier to deal with when you realize none of it matters. What you are, where you came from, let go of all that, and life gets simple.
Yeah, I hear you.
Is that so? Huh. Most of the chumps here act like I'm out of my gourd. Good to know someone else sees it my way. Anyway, lately I've taken to amusing myself with trading. Don't have much to work with, but I'm always happy to make a good deal. Let me know if you need something. I probably won't have it, but let me know anyway.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Now we're talking.
Thank you.
you got something to say.
Your thoughts?
I've been told the Valentine Detective Agency signs are an eyesore, but they sure bring in the business.
That's all.
Well, all right.
Hey.
Do something. Thing for you?
Acadia is far away enough from the Institute. We don't have to worry, right?
Circuitry is completely fried. Maybe if I react sensors? Pre-war junk into something usable. Now, do you mind telling me what you're doing here?
I'm a detective. I was hired to find you.
You're a what? You came all this way for me?
You left without telling your folks why. You must have known they'd be worried.
Look, my mom and dad, I mean, those people that were taking care of me, they wouldn't want me back. Not if they knew the truth.
What do you mean?
I'm not their daughter. I'm a synth. I thought if I just left, it would be easier for them. How would that conversation have gone anyway? I've been lying to you this whole time. Your real daughter is dead and I replaced her?
Do you have any proof that you're actually a synth?
Little things. Dreams of waking up in a lab, years I can't remember from when I was a kid. Not to mention how I never quite fit in back at home.
Kasumi, I think you're just confused. Everyone has doubts about who they are sometimes. It's part of life.
I really wish that was true. If I wasn't a synth, things would be so much simpler. Acadia isn't what I thought it was. There's more going on here than just the refuge. But I can't leave until I've gotten to the bottom of it. I've been running long enough.
What kind of problem is there in Acadia?
It's a long story. I just have to figure out how to... Wait. Wait, you find things. Track down answers. That's what you do, right? That's why you came after me. What if I told you that there's a secret? A big secret, here, on this island. Something way more important than just one lost girl.
What are you talking about?
Where to begin? You saw all those computers that Dimas hooked up to, right? They hold his memories, or offload data from his brain. Or maybe some combination of both? Well, Faraday asked me to help do some repairs on them. And, you know, I got curious. There's like a century's worth of life experiences in there. And that's when I see it. Data models Dima has been making. One was the fog taking over Far Harbor. Another was a nuclear detonation on the island. Plus, death counts. What if Dima is so open and welcoming because he's actually hiding something from us? A plan to wipe out the rest of the island.
We should get to the bottom of this. If Dima is putting on an act, we need to know.
You don't trust Dima? After you came all this way for him?
I didn't come to Acadia for him. I came here because this place offered answers. And now that I've found a place I belong, I'd rather not lose it all if Dima is secretly planning to destroy everything.
I'll help if I can. But that's not much to go on.
I know. I've been working on that, but I haven't had much luck. I keep seeing Dima, Faraday, and Chase head into the laboratory at the other end of the hall. Then they come out later looking like they've been arguing. There's actually a storage space right next to there. It'd be a perfect spot to hide and eavesdrop, but it's been locked up. I've also tried breaking into Faraday's terminal, since he and Dima are so close, but the security on it is crazy.
Eavesdropping on the next meeting sounds like our best bet. I already managed to get the door open.
You did? Great! Come back as soon as you found anything.
From one case to a new one. It's never easy for us, is it?
I swear, someone has the key to that storage room.
To accomplish this without bloodshed. Far Harbor and the Children of Adam have a right to exist on this island, the same as us.
They're going to kill each other, Dima. There's no stopping it. We need to pick a side now.
Haven't we already picked a side? Building the fog condensers around Far Harbor wasn't exactly a neutral act.
We couldn't stand by and let the people of this island die to the fog.
Just like you couldn't just leave the Cult of Adam without a home? Giving them the submarine base was a mistake. The Nucleus, as they're calling it, is basically one big fortified position.
Far Harbor had cast them out. They have strange beliefs, but they have always accepted us for what we are. And Confessor Martin was a friend.
Well, the new Confessor isn't. High Confessor Tectus is an unstable megalomaniac, and he's going to keep threatening us as long as we're helping Far Harbor.
Guys, can we talk about the elephant in the room? We keep dancing around it.
My old memory banks in the submarine base.
I can't believe you never told me about those. I have to wait until they become a security risk.
I know how it looks in hindsight, but at the time, it was an act of trust. I was honestly more worried they'd accidentally trip the pre-war security and get hurt, giving the children my old home, allowing them to safeguard my old memories. I thought our people would be working together.
Just how secure are the banks? How long do we have? And what's in them?
I've gone over this before, Chase. I don't know what's in them. That's how it works. It's as close to forgetting something as I have, but I've run some projections of worst case scenarios. If we do nothing and the wrong knowledge falls in the wrong hands.
So send me over there. I'll be in and out in a day.
We can't risk it. They know you're from Acadia. If you're caught or even seen, then it's war.
We should at least prepare her to go in. We're running out of options. I say we tell her how to crack into the memory banks.
You've been working on this without me?
It came up in a private moment, Chase. But yes, we've been writing a program that will let you access and download my memories. It's not going to be like a normal hack. You'll be breaking through a version of my own mental network. It'll consider you to be an intruder. I've loaded the program with some instructions I've recorded that will help guide you through it. I'm afraid it's difficult to explain without seeing it for yourself.
I'm finishing up some tweaks to the program right now. I'll leave a copy of it for you on my desk when I'm done.
Get the program, use it to break into the memory banks. Got it.
Hopefully you won't have to. We'll keep monitoring the situation. I only want you going in if we have no other choice.
Fingers everywhere on this island, and whatever's in his memories isn't something we can wait for someone else to find.
The detective's life isn't an easy one, but it
rarely lacks for excitement.
Dima.
What can I do for you?
I know you left some of your memories behind in an old submarine base, that you're worried the children of Adam will get to them.
You've been busy. I was hoping you were taking your time learning more about us. Huh. I suppose you have. Maybe this is an opportunity for both of us. I can't send any of my people without risking the children of Adam linking them back to Acadia. But you, you're new to the island.
All right, I'm listening.
Before I begin, how much do you know? Did you have any questions for me about Far Harbor, the children of Adam, or my memories?
You left your memories behind? How does that work?
As a prototype synth, my raw data capacity is limited. I began using computer banks to expand, to give me room to ponder, see new things. I had to leave some of my earliest memories behind when I left the subbase to the Children of Adam. I thought they were safe.
The Children of Adam on this island, you were helping them?
Yes. I know their faith in radiation as a type of god is a bit different, but who am I to judge? I was using a submarine base as a home when Martin and his followers stumbled inside. They had been cast out of Far Harbor for their beliefs. When I left to found Acadia, I knew the base would be in safe hands. They needed a home, a place to belong. Just like I did. But now Martin is gone, and his successor, Tectus, wants to finally end the feud with Far Harbor by letting the fog swallow them.
You're keeping Far Harbor safe, is that it?
Not exactly. They're fiercely independent, but the fog was starting to choke more and more of the island, so I proposed a trade. We would give them the technology to keep the fog at bay, in return for them being a lifeline to the outside world, a safe dock, and a place to buy supplies. Unfortunately, the Children of Adam view the radioactive fog as a holy portent, and their bloodied history with Far Harbor puts us at odds.
I know all I need to.
Then my plan is simple. Pose as a recruit, and infiltrate the Children of Adam. Gain access to their base in the old command center, guarded by some pre-war security measures. You'll find my memory banks. I'll give you the program you need in order to access my memories. Bring me anything you find. It's not going to be like a normal hack. You'll be breaking through a version of my own mental network. It'll consider you to be an intruder.
I've loaded the program with some instructions I've recorded that will help guide you through it. I'm afraid it's difficult to explain without seeing it for yourself.
Actually, I already have the program. I was thorough.
Well, I guess that just means I've picked the right person for the job. One more thing before you leave. Whatever you do, don't assault the children of Adam directly. Our ultimate goal must be to bring peace. If you attack them, they'll consider themselves at war with the outside world.
If we find anything suspicious in those memories of yours, we'll be back. Count on it.
Turns out Dima's earliest memories are in the hands of the children of Adam. He's afraid of what they're gonna find.
So, is that what those death projections were about? It wasn't Dima planning to destroy the island. He's worried the children of Adam will. Or is he still hiding something? What could be in those memories that he would leave them behind? Is there really something in them that's dangerous? Do you have a way in? Into his memories? Assuming you can get past the children of Adam, of course.
I got this program that Faraday and Dima wrote. It's supposed to help me access the memory banks.
Really? How would that work? When I was taking a peek in the computers he has here, Dima was hooked up to his chair. I was just tapping into it. I wonder if you'll need to, you know, connect to the old banks the way he does? Some kind of connection between your head and the computer. I'll bet that's it. And then Faraday's program would be translating Dima's thoughts and data, helping you through any security guarding it. I'm sorry, I'm making assumptions. It's just, well, it's a little exciting, isn't it? You'll let me know what you find? I'll keep an eye on things here.
So, say I get the memories. What then?
If it's something that would really threaten the island, then it's better out of the hands of the children of Adam. Or Far Harbor, even. And if Dima really can't be trusted, we'll have his own memories to confront him with.
I'll get Dima's memories, and then we'll figure things out from there.
Good luck.
I think we ought to talk.
Okay.
We've just been traveling for a while now. And I figured, especially after all that stuff with Dima, that you deserve to know more about me. So, is there anything you want to know?
What do you remember about the Institute?
It's all pretty hazy from back then, but now and then I get glimpses. Life inside the Institute, they keep you isolated. A single test chamber was my whole world for years, and someone was always watching. Then one day, you wake up on the other side. And that's it. They've cut you loose. Welcome to the brave new world, with such people in it.
What's with the outfit?
After I started the agency, it just seemed like the sort of thing a detective ought to wear. I got some old memories, pre-war. Faded to all heck of guys dressed like this, doing what I do. Putting on the hat and trench coat, I figured it'd let folks know I was serious about the whole thing. Clothes make the man and all that. Guess I felt they made me the man I wanted to be.
So who are you, Nick?
That's a question I've been trying to figure out myself for a long damn time. I know I'm a synth. Authentic Institute handiwork. But I'm still mechanical. Not bioengineered like the fancy synths giving everyone the willies these days. I get tune-ups now instead of checkups.
You remember when Dima was talking about the Institute's personality experiments? My memories. My personality. They're all lifted from some cop who volunteered for an experiment back before the war. They scanned his brain and copied it onto the hardware that runs between my ears Don't know why they chose to make a robot based on some pre-war cop instead of a math genius or a bioengineer. But hey, maybe that's why the Institute tossed me in the garbage instead of turning me into one of their people snatchers.
Wait, the original Nick was from my time?
Sure was. Which meant when I finally ended up out here, it was quite the rude awakening. I remember waking up one day in a garbage heap, a body in tatters and a head full of memories belonging to a man who'd been dead for 200 years. Suffice to say, it was a confusing couple of weeks. Folks didn't really know much about synths back then, so when I finally ran into people, they mostly treated me with caution rather than hostility. But the kids, they weren't afraid. I think his name was Jim. The first person to actually speak to me after I got the boot from the Institute. My first human contact in this world. Grilled me for an hour. Once they'd seen I wasn't going to hurt anyone, the other folks in the neighborhood came out to ogle the mechanical man. It eventually turned into a pretty swell soiree. A local mechanic even gave me a once-over free of charge. There's people, they treated me like a human being. I've been trying to return the favor ever since. It's a surprisingly rare trait out here sometimes. It's something I've noticed you got a fondness for. Part of the reason I've stuck around this long.
Where's that town? We should go visit.
I tried to go back and say thanks, once I'd gotten myself established. But the place was wiped off the map. Raiders. Don't know what happened to the people.
If you're good to people, they'll be good back. That's something I've always believed.
Couldn't agree more. Well, I expect you're about as bored as can be listening to me rattle my skeletons. You should probably head out.